Tonight, the NFL, American Airlines, Marriott, and even Mitt Romney and John McCain all agree with me. Arizona Governor Jan Brewer needs to veto this so-called religious freedom bill that would actually legalize discrimination against gays and lesbians. Now, she has until Saturday to make her decision. Here's my comment to her. Governor, one of the greatest achievements we ever had in America is simply this. We got rid of six words. Those six words, we don't serve your kind here. Now, we take it for granted today, but it took a civil war and the civil rights movement, a century of struggle, to get rid of those six words. And now you have some folks in your state, they want to take those six words, they want to wrap them in religious garb and reinscribe them in law and ram them back into American society. No way, Governor, you got to veto this bill. And Newt, I hope she does it.
Well, look, I think she will veto this bill, but I also think that if you look at the total array of political pressure, it tells you when political correctness refuses to even have a serious conversation. The fact is, there are very real issues coming down the road about the power of the government to coerce people. Some of these cases are pathetic. A photographer who says, I'm happy to take pictures of gays and lesbians, but I don't want to do it for a wedding. It's against my beliefs. A baker who says, I'm happy to bake cakes, but I don't want to bake, and I'll bake it for gays and lesbians, but I don't want to bake it for a wedding. Individuals now. And you now have the full power of the state and the full power of the NFL and all these groups you're talking about piling on for political correctness. Well, I think it's a big issue and one we're going to come back to again tonight.
Well, I'm looking forward to it, and I just think about my uncles who are watching, who sat in at those individual businesses trying to be served hamburgers, and I think history's going to be on our side. In the crossfire tonight, CNN commentator LZ Granderson, who is a gay rights advocate, and we also have Virginia's former attorney general, the great Republican Ken Cuccinelli. I want to go to you first. I mentioned my uncles. This is big for America. We're trying to figure out this balancing point here.
Sure.
You've thought about this a lot. Help me understand, if somebody is sincere in their religious beliefs, stipulate to that.
Right.
What's the difference between them putting up a sign that says no gays allowed versus no blacks allowed? Sincere in their religious beliefs about it, what's the difference?
Well, because you do get to test that. And we've had a Religious Freedom Restoration Act at the federal levels for over 20 years. Newt Gingrich voted for that back in the day. We've had it in the states since 1996 when the Supreme Court said it doesn't cover the states. Arizona has had this law on the books for 15 years, and none of the parade of horribles, and most of what you said, Van, is just utterly inaccurate. And most of that parade of horribles,
we didn't have a civil rights movement to get rid of.
No, I'm talking about Arizona. I'm talking about Arizona and your characterization of what's being attempted there. The last 15 years, they've had a law in place that would supposedly allow what you've described. And what's happened?
Nothing's happened in Arizona.
One thing's happening now in that part of the country. And Newt Gingrich used the baker and the photographer, and those are real world examples.
None of those happened in Arizona.
And those folks, the plaintiffs mm-hmm. who assaulted legally these people who just wanted to be safe in their religious practice.
Listen, I'm going to ask you a question, sir. Please answer my question.
You're okay with violating people's faith.
Here's my question to you.
Here's
my question to you.
You're conceding that
point. What is the difference between a business owner saying, no blacks are allowed here versus no gays are allowed?
Show me a religion that says that.
Oh, well, there are plenty of religions.
Mormonism at one point.
Well, I mean, you want to get in?
I'm sitting here, and I'm trying not to jump over here and go, what are you talking about? But I'm going to do it anyway. What are you talking about? I mean, that is just straight up, plain, nothing but discrimination. Any other way of phrasing it?
So you're okay with people who sincerely hold religious beliefs to violate those religious beliefs?
Let's just be real clear.
Yeah, I'm trying to get to that.
Okay, we're going
to
be real clear. This isn't about religion. This is about the Christian faith. Because no one's saying, why is there a war in Ramadan? No one is saying, why is there a war in Yom Kippur? This is about Christianity.
Hey, look, that's a great point.
Let me finish.
Been used by Muslims to protect themselves.
Allow me to finish. Now, once you've decided, and I guess we can safely agree, this is basically being driven by the Christian faith, I'm looking at the Bible, and I'm like going, where in the Bible does Jesus say no to people? He's always bringing people in. So are you really using this under the umbrella of your religious faith?
First of all,
or are you wrapping your homophobia around the Bible and trying to find scripture to justify your homophobia? Just because you're uncomfortable with something does not mean it's against your religious faith.
Because you disagree with me doesn't mean I'm a homophobe, does it?
Well,
will you agree to that?
Well, I would agree.
Will you agree to that?
You,
can you have an intellectual disagreement that isn't personalized?
We all know your history. You've made several remarks over the years that I would classify as homophobic.
Have a discussion
I would say you personally are probably a homophobe.
So you walked into at the beginning of a discussion and said, I'm a bigot, and so my position doesn't count.
Based upon your series of comments you've made.